Is there a problem?
I'm doing a little follow-up on the Mary Bishop homicide.
We've already given our statements.
Unfortunately, Emily's statement is full of holes. I need to hear what happened that night directly from her.
She already told D.A. Lansing what happened. And everyone else's statement backs her up, including that of Lucky Spencer, an officer in your department.
Why are you asking? Have you found some new evidence?
I am going to take the ones you...
About Mary Bishop's death?
Jason didn't want me to.
What was his reason?
He's paranoid, that's why. I'm sorry, Emily, I know you love him, but let's be honest here. Jason's an alleged criminal, been arrested dozens of times, doesn't answer any questions, am I right?
No, I don't want to answer anything without my lawyers about it.
Look, Emily is Jason's little sister, and he adores her, but I don't agree with his methods of protecting her. He told her to follow his example, to stay silent, even though she had done nothing wrong.
I'd like to hear from Emily.
It happened exactly the way Nicholas said. Jason came into the room. He asked me not to answer, and he's my brother. I respect him, so that's what I did.
But after you gave a statement to Rick Lansing?
Yeah, I convinced Emily to cooperate.
With some help from Lucky and Elizabeth, right?
They encouraged me to make a statement, yes.
After the four of you came up with a cover story.
No,
whoever
Mac
killed
not,
Mary
no.
Bishop had medical knowledge to alter the meds. Elizabeth is a nurse, and you are pre-med.
So what? There's tons of nurses and doctors in the hospital.
None of whom had motive.
Well, they could have been paid to change the meds. Why jump to the conclusion that it was Emily?
I'm not jumping to anything, Nicholas. I'm trying to find another suspect. Someone capable of killing Mary and covering their tracks.
I'm partial to white flowers.
Oh, white lilies would be my pick.
Oh, it's an elegant choice.
Yes, and classic, in keeping with the tone we're trying to set.
I must be hallucinating here.
What are you up to now?
Oh, my darlings. In honor of your betrothal, Tracy and I have decided to end the hostilities between our families and join together in helping you plan the perfect wedding.
General Hospital.
Woman, now, I certainly hope that the Port Charles Police Department has the good sense to have dropped the charges.
Commissioner Scorpio. Yeah. Excuse me. What do you got?
What's going on?
A wedding, I hope.
Oh, right. Last time I saw you, you were opposed to Emily and our wedding.
And you were against anyone being happy, period.
Helena and I have had a change of heart.
Really? Oh, really? So when did you experience this joint epiphany?
Well, we struck up a conversation and realized how much we have in common.
We're both from powerful, wealthy families.
With a great deal of influence in the community.
And we realized the two of you must really be in love, to have surmounted all of the obstacles in front of you.
So we thought, why not let bygones be bygones?
Did we just slip into a parallel universe?
We had some wonderful ideas for the wedding.
Yes, now the wedding can be right out here in the garden.
How about at sunset?
Oh, perfect. The light is lovely at that time of day.
And we can have the reception at the Quartermain Mansion.
Oh, a celebration of joy.
And healing.
Absolutely not.
Oh, Nicholas,
You won't be attending our wedding, much less planning it.
We're making all the decisions on our own.
Sure. Well, there's been a break in the Mary Bishop homicide. I'm afraid you're going to have to come downtown.
Sonny has always been a little...
Why do they need me to come in?
Someone stepped forward with new evidence.
What sort of evidence?
As your attorney, I was excluded from the interview due to a conflict of interest.
What's going on, Rick?
Well, apparently Commissioner Scorpio here went to an outside source to investigate Mary Bishop's murder. That source has found a nurse who can positively ID the person who gave Mary the medication that killed her.
That's impossible.
Really?
Elizabeth and I were there and we saw no one.
Well, she saw you there at the time, Lucky. She also said that she saw exactly what you did. Now, if that's true, it appears you're covering up the murder.
What was so important you stayed with the phone?
Died. Now, either your powers of perception are surprisingly poor, or there's something you're leaving out.
The thing I said is in my statement.
Okay, well, as long as you understand, withholding information could cost you your badge, Lucky. Mac, I assume that you went outside the PCPD and you asked Felicia to investigate because you suspected that Lucky here was covering for Nicholas and Emily. She found proof. I want Officer Spencer suspended without pay pending
investigation. But you can't do that.
I cannot do what? Uncover the truth?
She rose to the defense of a friend. That's a perfectly natural impulse.
Ah, yes, it is, of course. Is that all that was?
Yes.
Okay, I may want to file charges of obstruction of justice against Officer Spencer here. You may want to stick around. You can talk to Miss Davis here about representation. Maybe she can put together a package deal.
Are you finished?
Not quite. I'm going to talk to Nurse Harrison here. She's going to look through the photos and ID the person who actually gave Mary the pills.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be okay. You know what? I couldn't do it any other way.
You could lose your job or worse. Maybe I should come forward.
No, I think we should wait. It might be a trick.
Emily, have you talked to your attorney?
I left messages for Justice, but he hasn't called me back. Maybe I should call Jason and...
Don't do me a favor. Don't get your brother into this. He'll just make it worse.
Look, Emily needs a lawyer now. Can you represent her, at least in the short term?
I'll do the best that I can, but I need to know what I'm dealing with. Did you take the medication to Mary?
Yeah, but I swear I didn't tamper with it.
Well, with any luck, the nurse won't ID Emily. The nurse is the killer. She could ID Emily to frame her.
How can I help you if you won't tell me what's got you worried?
It's nothing. Jason, it's a temporary panic attack. That's all. I've got a lot.
You remember seeing anyone else outside the ICU room other than Emily?
No.
Then where are these alleged witnesses?
Hiding somewhere?
Listen, the only other person who could have been in the room was the killer.
Nurse Harris has been on leave of absence, taking care of her family since the night that Mary died.
That's quite a coincidence.
It could be a legitimate one. Her brother-in-law was killed in a car accident. He had no life insurance, and Nurse Harris's sister had three little children.
How long had this nurse been working at General Hospital?
10 years. She keeps to herself. She has a clean record.
And how did she happen to be watching Mary Bishop's room?
She was sneaking a smoke on the stairwell in the hallway. The door was cracked. She said that she saw a young woman with long brown hair steal a cup of medicine from the cart and go into Mary Bishop's room.
She wasn't in a nurse's uniform, which struck me as odd. I assumed that she was a friend and didn't think anything more of it, until I read about the patient's murder in the paper.
Mm-hmm. You sure you can identify this woman?
Yeah. She passed right by the stairway door.
Is she one of the women in these photos?
If that nurse IDs me, it proves that I lied in my statement and that Elizabeth and Lucky lied to come.
Hey, you know what? Don't worry. Just because I've been suspended doesn't mean I can't keep looking into it. Thank you very much for your help.
You're welcome. Well?
She made a positive ID. The person that Nurse Harris saw go into Mary Bishop's room with the medicine that killed her is Emily.
From ABC.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to place you under arrest.
No. No.
The Quartermans and I will have her out on bail faster than you can get her in lockup. Don't waste your time.
You on your own recognizance, but please don't leave town. It goes for all of you.
Emily, sorry. I didn't realize it would come to this.
I guess we should forget our wedding plans.
No, yeah, come here. Listen to me. Right? I promised that I would marry you. And nothing's gonna stop me from doing that. Okay?
Oh, it's all there.
Thank you. This will be so helpful to my sister and her children.
Just stick with the story that we gave you. You saw Emily Quartermain go into Mary Bishop's hospital room with the medication.
You'll be asked to testify in court, for which you will be paid an additional fee.
Oh, I'll be convincing.
Oh, yes. Yes, we expect you to be. Just remember, it is essential that Emily Quartermain is convicted and sent to prison for the murder of Mary Bishop.
You denied giving Mary the meds that killed her. Lucky and I backed you up. This should be over, and instead, it's just getting worse. And now Lucky's been suspended from the force for lying.
Hey, Nicholas is being prosecuted for shooting Mary, and you're being charged with overdosing her with meds.
And I'm under suspicion for being part of the cover-up.
I honestly don't see how this could get worse.
Enough already!
So how do you like Casa?
Mary Bishop killed two people. Tried to kill Emily and stole months of my life. And let me tell you, it stops right now. We're not gonna sit around and complain anymore about what happened. We're gonna take action right now.
Okay. What do you have in mind?
Emily and I committed to be married. So let's plan a wedding.
Nicholas, being optimistic is all well and good, but we need to look at the big picture here.
Which is?
Mary was murdered. After you shot her and sent her to the hospital, you guys are planning a wedding. It's going to make it look like you don't care.
Why should they? Mary tried to ruin their lives.
You know what she means.
It looks like we all got Mary out of the way so the two of you could get
so
married.
But that's ridiculous. I'm so tired.
Okay, wait. Maybe some people will buy into it. Maybe even D.A. Lansing.
Nicholas, we need to be smart about this. We don't want to hurt ourselves even more.
The intelligent thing, the only thing to do is to show the entire world that we have nothing to hide, that you and I love each other, and that our friends believe in us as much as you and I believe in each other, okay? We do that, we stick to that, we hold our heads up high, and no one can hurt us, okay?
We need to make a guest list.
We need to find a space.
Hire a caterer, start thinking about decorations.
Much better attitude, thank you.
If the wedding is what you guys want, then that's what you're going to get. Come on, Lucky, let's go.
Where?
You're the best man. I'm the maid of honor. That means we do all the grunt work. I'm going to call you about a florist because I think I know this perfect one.
Did you hear that? She said a florist. We're going to go find a florist. If you ever doubted my love, there's the proof.
I never doubted it for a second. But I already knew how much I loved you. But I never understood how much I needed you until this very minute.
Way too long to make you my wife. I'm not gonna let anything stand in the way of that.
Any preference on colors?
No.
The black tie or more informal?
You choose.
Live band or DJ?
Either one, doesn't matter.
Nicholas, don't you have an opinion about any of this?
The only thing that I care about is that when that ceremony is over, you and I will never be separated again. That's all I care about.
But what?
What?
What about traditions? You know, are you at least willing to follow a few of them?
Sure. What'd you have in mind?
The one that says an engaged couple shouldn't make love until after they're married.
I haven't heard of that one.
Well, I have, you know, and I've always thought it was very romantic.
Couldn't we follow some other tradition, like something old, new, borrowed blue, that one? Can't we do that one?
Well, we're going to do that one, too. You know, not to mention the throwing of the bouquet and feeding each other the cake.
Oh, my God, you got me. I can't believe you got me. So,
No, Nicholas, women take their weddings very seriously. I thought you would have known that.
What? We're talking, it could be weeks. Here, months.
Yeah, well, kind of an incentive to work quickly, isn't it?
More like an incentive to elope right now.
No, come on, Nicholas. It'll be fine. Oh, we can still kiss and cuddle. Well, no, you know what? I think that could be a problem. You know?
Why?
Maybe we should stop sleeping in the same bed. That way we won't be tempted.
tempted just by hearing your name.
Really?
Yes. I love you. With my whole body. And I want to show you how much, as often as I possibly can.
Well, see, that's the thing about traditions. Sometimes they outlive their usefulness, and you have to start a new one.
How about this one? The engaged couple make love whenever and wherever they want.
You know what, Nicholas? I have a feeling that one may catch on.
Yeah.
Wedding is very stressful, Nicholas. If I flip out and turn into Bridezilla, I don't want you there to witness it.
What is it you're afraid that I'll see?
Who knows? I crying jags, screaming tantrums because the flowers I want are out of season, indecision over shoes and dresses, total meltdown.
Even if you change overnight into a screaming hysteric who thinks that her choice of flowers is going to alter the course of history, I'm selfish enough to ride that.
Oh, it's selfish.
Yes, yes. See, I'm getting the girl of my dreams. You're getting a bankrupt felon.
The prince of my dreams. Seriously, Nicholas, it should have meaning for both of us. And, you know, I was thinking, would you mind if we got married in that little church in the woods where we made our promises to each other?
That little church is exactly where I want to marry.
So, we know where we're going to have the ceremony.
Yeah, but you know, if we were sane, we'd elope. You know that.
You know, my family's crazy, but I love them, and I want them to be there.
Yeah, and they're about to be my family, too. I should probably start getting used to them.
You really don't mind?
No, well, I mean, if we're standing at the altar about to pledge our lives to each other and one of the quartermains jumps to their feet to object, then yeah, then I'll mind. Anything short of that, I think I can handle.
So we're doing this.
Yeah.
We're getting married.
That's right. And nothing and no one is ever going to stop us.
Come in.
What's got you so engrossed?
the sketch of a wedding dress I'm considering.
Yeah?
Which you can't see yet.
All right. Well, if you can't find anything you like, we can always have Elena and Tracy decide, since they've both teamed up to promote this happy occasion.
I was hoping they weren't serious.
Seemed pretty serious to me.
Yeah, I shuddered to think what those two would do if they were actually able to influence our wedding.
Yeah. Don't worry, we'll elope before that happens.
Yeah, that's not such a bad idea. Yeah, we could do it tonight. Hop on the jag, find a justice of the peace.
Don't tempt me, all right? Because I'm doing all of this stuff here just for you. I'd be just as happy if we skipped it.
Yeah, seriously, Nicholas, maybe we should.
Are you serious? Because if you are, I'll go right now.
Hey, I know we're early, but we just wanted to help.
Help with what?
I knew it.
Your only engagement party here tonight?
What?
Well, we didn't plan a party.
I think we have a pretty good idea who may have.
I'm not sure I can keep up with the lies. I mean, I'm afraid I might slip or confuse Emily with Elizabeth and point the finger at the wrong girl.
They are nothing alike. Elizabeth is the short one with the pouty lips. You'll keep the story straight. You have no choice.
Look, I'm a wreck. My hands, they're shaking.
Take that. It'll calm your nerves.
Thank you.
They want us to forget what they're really doing, framing Emily for Mary's murder.
Yeah, as if we could.
All right, you know what? Let's just put our heads together. Sort out what happened the night that Mary was killed. Maybe something will jump out at one of us. Emily left Mary's room and found Elizabeth with the meds cart, right?
I realized I'd forgotten the water, so I left them alone. I picked up Mary's medication. I thought about how easy it would be to switch it or overdose her, and then I took the pills into her room.
And I saw you come out.
Wait a minute. Back up. Are you thinking that you somehow unconsciously switched Mary's meds for the ones that killed her?
The thought has occurred to me,
okay,
yeah.
Well, get it out of your head, because that's impossible. A switch that specific would have taken conscious thought, and it couldn't have happened in a second.
Which means the lethal dose must have already been in the cup when Elizabeth brought the meds.
Mary would have died that night, no matter who administered the drug.
Yeah, so Emily was just in the wrong place at the wrong time.
That's brilliant, you guys.
Yeah, too bad we can't prove it.
And don't forget, the police have an eyewitness who swears that she saw me go into Mary's room with med cup.
A witness none of us ever saw.
Exactly, which is why I think that Nurse Harris was never actually in the room. Someone just paid her to say she was.
I'm only doing this, lying to the police and taking your money because my sister is in such need.
We all have our price.
I only hope that God will forgive me for this.
Oh, God's wrath will pale in comparison to mine if you don't follow our instructions to the letter. If you deviate even one iota...
You don't have to paint me a picture. I get your message loud and clear.
Then we shouldn't have a problem.
Florence Nightingale's a little too jumpy for my taste. The police could put some pressure on her. She could cave and admit that she not only was not on the floor the night Mary was killed, but we paid her to say she was.
Unless we keep Nurse Harris on point, neither of us gets what we want.
Yeah, sweet little virtuous Emily in prison with no chance of inheriting my mother's money.
And Nicholas free to marry someone more pliable. An actual bloodline would be nice.
There's one loose end. Emily did not kill Mary. Someone did. It was you, wasn't it?
I'm not leaving poor Charles.
So, according to the caterer, Elena hired him.
It'd be nice if she bothered to tell us.
Yeah, well, she knew we wouldn't participate in any farce of a party thrown by her and Tracy.
Hey, you guys, I'm really worried about Lucky.
What?
He just took off with that look in his eye. If he tries to accuse Elena and Tracy of framing you, and they realize he means to expose them, there's no telling what those witches will do.
Hey.
Oh, hi. You know, it's kind of traditional to tell the parents when you're going to have an engagement party. Your father isn't even back from a conference in Baltimore.
So you probably found out about this before Nicholas and I did.
Now, how would that work?
Evidently, Elena and Tracy have entered into some unholy alliance, and...
What the hell was she thinking?
Interesting choice of dress for a party.
Oh, you think? Yeah, Rick's an interesting choice for a date. You forget that he's prosecuting Emily and me? So out of respect for my aunt, I won't ask you to leave and stay away from Emily and me.
That was pleasant.
He is understandably upset.
Well, I told you that he wasn't going to be pleased with my presence here, but you wouldn't take no for an answer. So why is that, Alexis? Why did you really bring me here? Elena and my mother. Now, that's a scary pairing.
Yeah, tell me about it. You know, this party, Ned, Nicholas and I had nothing to do with it. We didn't even know about it until people started showing up. You know, the new best friends, Elena and Tracy, put this together without our knowledge or consent. And you know what? Consent matters. I'm going to put an end to this charade right now, excuse me.
No, you're not. You sure you got enough postage?
Positive.
You know it's not smart to send large sums of cash through the mail. I mean, what if somebody stole it?
Oh, that isn't money. I'm sending my sister some pictures.
Yeah, I guess the only picture.
pictures that are in this package should probably have pictures of dead presidents on cash that you received to make sure that Emily takes the rap for Mary Bishop's murder.
No, I...
Don't try and deny it. Please just tell me who paid you.
You seem to be under the impression that you know me very well. And that is a mistake. However, I will indulge your curiosity. You're right. I had absolutely no use for Mary Bishop. She was a loathsome little creature, high-strung and useless. Well, she was even more unsuitable for Nicholas than Emily. Well, I could have had her killed many times, but I thought about it. But I didn't do it. Can you say the same?
One, I didn't know her. Two, I don't care who Nicholas sleeps with. Ergo, no motive.
Well, as you so astutely pointed out, someone did. And that someone is not likely to come forward with it to save Emily. So, I think we congratulate ourselves for a job well done and get about the business of this evening. We have a party to host.
Of course, I'm curious.
I'm sorry, Officer Spencer, but I must have been out of town the day that the Port Charles Police Department decided that it was a crime for one family member to take care of another.
You know, most people, they would have sent a check, a wire, a bank transfer, but you just couldn't afford that kind of paper trail. I'm sorry, Miss Harris, but I'm going to have to take you into the PCPD for questioning. Which now the only thing left for you to do is just try to make it easy for yourself.
Wait. What's going to happen to me?
Probably be arrested for obstruction of justice, that's for starters. Could be named co-conspirator in the death of Mary Bishop.
Wait, but I had nothing to do with that.
Won't matter to Elena and Tracy. I'll just turn this frame around on you so fast you won't even know it hit you. Which means you probably spend the rest of your life in prison. Or you could just try to work with me.
Ridiculous party.
To lull my grandmother and Tracy into a false sense of security and make them think that their plan's working. I mean, if Lucky is on to something, then we need to give him time to follow up without them trying to head him off.
But don't you think it's going to raise a red flag when Helena and Tracy realize that Lucky's not here?
Yes. And in the meantime, we'll go along with the party and then we'll just keep an eye on Helena and Tracy, okay?
Maybe we should add insult to injury and actually enjoy it.
Excuse me. Hi. I just wanted you to know that I'm not as insensitive as it may appear from my choice of dates. There's a reason that I brought him, there's a plan, and you need to trust me.
Seem a little cold.
Well, what were you expecting?
Well, I'm not sure. Well, you overheard me speaking to Alexis at the cellar.
Part about our marriage being over, yeah, I heard it.
Elizabeth,
Rick, really, there's no need to explain. You're right. Our marriage is over, and so are we. But since you brought it up, I just have to ask. Would you be pursuing a future with Alexis if she didn't have a past with Sonny?
May I have your attention, please? I would like to propose a toast to Emily, my future wife.
Here, here,
here, here. Here.
Oh, and to our gracious hostesses, Tracy Quartermain and Helena Cassadine.
Yes.
We thank you both for this wonderful surprise. But most of all, for your good wishes. May they return to you twofold.
I'll drink to that.
It appears to be...
It's beautiful.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'm not sure. Yeah, I should probably hide it so Helena doesn't find out my designer's name. She'd probably call and order it in black or something.
You know, do the opposite. Keep it out. As an affirming symbol of your future with Nicholas. Because you guys are crazy in love and you have nothing to hide.
So, are we having fun yet? Be sure to let me know.
I'm sorry it's so painful for you to have to be my escort.
No, actually, you've been surprisingly tolerable. I'm sure it's because you're loving the fact that it's in such an uncomfortable position.
Actually, I'm finding it slightly amusing.
Well, frankly, I'm glad that Elaine and Tracy showed up. Maybe they can wear the bad guest onus for a while. What?
Look at them. Take a good long look at them. They are in love. They have their whole lives together. Do you honestly think she is capable of killing anyone with
no
Mary Bishop?
You know what? I don't know. The fact of the matter is, I wish I had something, anything that would point me someplace else. But unfortunately, Emily and Elizabeth and Lucky compromised themselves from the very beginning by lying. And while we're on the subject, you know what? Speaking of lying, why don't you be honest with me? Did you actually just bring me here so that you convinced me to change my mind about Emily? Or did you bring me here because, I don't know, maybe you enjoy my company?
Maybe.
Maybe's not an answer.
Mother, it's not like you to be a wallflower.
Darling, this party isn't about me. It's the celebration of Emily and Nicholas.
Oh, please. You don't give a flying fig about Nicholas and Emily. And this is your attempt to impress Felicia with your ante of the bride routine, so then she'll think you're deserving of grandmother's inheritance. Am I right? I think I'm right. It's not going to work. Unless this is a lot more sinister than it appears.
Excuse me, but if I could get everybody's attention, please. So sorry I was delayed, but I had to get a very special wedding gift for the bride and groom. I have proof that Helena and Tracy framed Emily for murder. Mailing the bribe money she sent to her sister, she admitted that Helena and Tracy paid her to lie about seeing Emily enter into Mary's room with the pills that killed her.
She's a liar.
Sounds plausible to me.
You know, I know better than most just how conniving and hateful you can be. But to frame Emily for murder, there's no coming back from this, Mother.
What? Why? And why Emily?
Oh, that's easy. The money. Your mother, Dylan, wanted to make sure Emily was out of the running for Lila's inheritance.
I can't believe you think I'd stoop so low.
We don't think it, we know it. And now Felicia's gonna know it.
Oh, please, this is absurd. To be accused with no proof, other than Lucky's desperate attempt to prove himself innocent of murder and conspiracy charges.
Where's Nurse Harris now?
Somewhere safe. And she's ready to tell us everything.
Oh, Grandmother, you set out to destroy us. Instead, you set us free. Thank you. Now leave. I want you out of this house and out of our lives forever. Let's go.
Not until I am finished. Pet, defy my wishes. Marry. Embrace happiness when and where you can, because your joy is fleeting. My curse is upon you, Nicholas and Emily. Your joy will bring nothing but pain and sorrow to you and yours for as long as you both shall live.
Oh, my God.
Wait.
Oh, my God. Whew.
She go?
You don't want to leave without talking to the cops now, do you?
Nice work for a suspended officer. Why don't you bring Nurse Harris in for a statement? Congratulations. You may have gotten Emily off.
You okay?
Yeah, a little shaky. Yeah, not that I believe in curses, but... Oh, my God.
Oh.
Nurse Harris, beginning. Other lives, many other lives, will be damaged or ruined if you insist on marriage.
Who do you think? You're kidding. You are the curse. You say the words, you carry them out, and that's exactly what you did tonight. Nurse Harris is dead because you killed her. And blaming it on the curse is the same as a confession.
And Tracy is a witness.
Me?
Well, yeah, you'll testify, won't you?
I'm giving you fair warning, Durant. Stay away from Carly.
You know... now that you've been gracious enough to confess to murder, Emily and I can marry in peace. Thank you.
I admitted no such thing.
Oh, well, we all heard. Right, Tracy?
All I have been hearing for too tedious long is a bunch of bombastic hoo-ha about some ridiculous curse. Emily, don't you understand why I don't approve of this marriage? Who needs to be any closer to the Cassadines? They're all nuts.
That's funny, because you didn't seem to think that way when you were working with Helena.
I chose to overcome some serious misgivings to join with Helena to throw you an engagement party. I considered it an olive branch to show you my support despite my grave doubts. How was I supposed to know that in the middle of the festivities, she would start spouting arcane curses?
I merely stated a fact. Nicholas and Emily will never be happy together.
Can you give it a rest?
Oh. You killed Mary, intending to frame Emily for her. Then you dig up this nurse Harris and pay her to lie and implicate Emily. And then you kill her when she wanted to retract her statement. Congratulations, Tracy. Your alliance with my grandmother here has made you an accomplice in two murders. I'd tread carefully from now on if I were you. If my grandmother doubts your loyalty, you'll be next on her hit list. You have a pleasant evening.
Had you not been at the front door right as I was getting ready to knock, I mean, I've lost my courage and bailed.
You're always welcome here, Lois.
You know, I have been out on the pier so many times looking at this place, but never been inside until now. It is, certainly
gothic.
Impressive.
Atmospheric.
Yeah, you should have seen it before we, de-gargoyled.
You know, I actually think that your family is even weirder than Emily's. And that's saying something. So how'd you turn out to be so normal?
Uh-oh, I'm not, really.
By the way, I am really sorry I didn't make the engagement party, but I had a prior commitment. But thank you. It was so sweet of you to invite me.
We didn't.
What he means is we didn't invite anyone. We didn't even know about the
Helena,
party.
Helena and Tracy ambushed us.
Yeah, and then Helena saw the need to put a curse on our marriage.
Didn't she do that to some other couple a long time ago?
Laura and Luke, yes, my mother.
Laura, right. Never fear, because the best way to counteract a curse is with a blessing. And I happen to have one right here. For you.
What is it?
Come here. I'm going to open it up. Take a look.
What?
It's your grandmother's dress. Lila was kind enough to let me wear it when I got married to Ned, and now it's your turn. I think this should be enough to ward off any bad wishes from Helena.
The way you looked in this dress, the way you glowed.
It was the happiest day of my life.
Yeah, well, I was honored to be included as a last-minute bridesmaid.
And now look, it's your turn to be married.
Thank you for remembering the dress, Lois, and bringing it to me.
Your grandmother would be so happy for you. Now, I'm going to get out of your way and leave you with this gorgeous hubby-to-be of yours.
All right, don't be a stranger, okay?
Oh, you got it. But could you do most of the visiting, because this place gives me the serious heebie-jeebies.
Bye.
I'm not supposed to see, right?
Come here, you. First of all, I'm not superstitious. And even if I were, it's only bad luck for the groom to see the bride in the dress on the wedding day. It's perfectly safe for you to see me holding it weeks ahead of time.
I'm sure you look beautiful, eh?
You're so good for my ego. When the sketch of the wedding dress I was considering got burned, you know, we thought that it was a bad omen. And instead, it turned out to be a good thing. You know, this dress feels like a love note from grandmother, you know, saying that she approves and wishes us well. You know, grandmother was a diehard romantic. She always wanted me to find the love of my life, and now I have, and I'm not going to let anything, including Helena's asinine curse, keep me from marrying.
Oh, God.
Oh. wine.
I'm so sorry.
No,
sorry.
It's no big deal. Look, I'll take it to the cleaners tomorrow. I'll have someone, cut it.
Emily, it's your
try to pass
grandmother's
it.
Wedding dress. It's an heirloom that means something to you, and I just ruined it.
Nicholas, you didn't ruin it.
Yeah, it's just like I ruined everything when I grabbed Mac's gun and shot Mary with it. I mean,
look,
if I had just...
You fired to protect me.
What I did led you to being framed for murder. I mean, what if Elaine is right? What if this is just the beginning?
What do you mean?
What if this Cassadine curse is for real?
Boy, you really are into this whole fitness thing. Isn't Lily to be running?
I laid the dress out to dry in one of the guest rooms, and I'll take it to the cleaners tomorrow, and with any luck, this thing will come out.
With any luck, you won't be prosecuted for murder. With any luck, I'll get a suspended sentence for manslaughter. With any luck.
Nicholas,
What?
Don't you realize that you're doing Helena's work for her? You're seeing bad omens where they don't exist.
Come on. You can't deny that some rather unfortunate events have surrounded our wedding plans lately.
What about the good things? Like your memory returning when I needed you the most. Or me surviving Mary's knife attack. Or Lois showing up with the wedding dress, which stained or not. Is like a vote of confidence. Yeah, you and I have been through so much, and it's taught me the most important lesson of my life. I think that love is stronger than fear. It's stronger than hate. It's stronger than greed or vendettas or curses. And our love will see us through anything, Nicholas, even this way.
Okay.
Did you actually see this woman?
So close we can practically touch them, so who could possibly believe in a curse on a night like this?
Yeah, well, not all our problems are going to vanish as quickly as that storm.
Maybe I can help.
Jason, tell Michael you don't like my father's job, not...
In connection with Mary's death, I doubt you could help us with that.
No, but I may be able to improve your financial situation.
Oh, yeah, how's that?
I'm looking to expand my shipping interests. Buying into Cassadine Industries would be advantageous.
So why should we trust you? You lied to Nicholas about who he was, and then you stayed friendly with Mary Bishop even after the truth came to light.
I felt sorry for Mary Bishop, and I had no idea she was mentally ill. And I certainly did nothing to encourage her murderous rampage, which, as you know, resulted in the death of my niece.
What makes you think I'll say yes to this?
Well, you're in a weak financial position to begin with, which has only been worsened by the court battle over your estate when you were presumed dead and your erratic behavior.
Look,
as you resurfaced.
If you're feeling charitable, there are worthier causes than the Cassadine finances.
Nicholas, you're smart and resourceful. I'm sure that when you're free to do so, that you will run Cassadine Industries to the best of your abilities. Now, from a business standpoint, an alliance with your firm, it could be useful to both of us.
I'll need some time to consider it.
I'll be in touch.
I don't trust that man.
Yeah, I'm not sure I do either.
Nicholas, please. Promise me that you won't even consider his offer.
Alcazar is much more dangerous than Helena's supposed curse.
Look, this is all very confusing.
If I decide to do business with Lorenzo Alcazar, I won't get involved in anything illegal.
How do you know you won't? He's a criminal. Nicholas, he must have hundreds of ways of hiding his money.
Do you trust me?
Of course I do.
Then don't worry, all right? I'm a businessman. I know how to protect my interests.
Why would you even consider this? Alcazar has lied to you so many times.
For one thing, I need the money, and he's right. It could be advantageous to us both.
So find another partner, someone honest, like Jax.
Jax, I have nothing to offer Jax. And Alcazar came to me. And besides, come on, we have a wedding to pay for, you know, a new life to start together. Come on.
Nicholas, I would rather live above Kelly's than have you risk your life like that.
All right, what's this really about, Emily?
What? I don't have a right to be concerned.
Am I supposed to be against Lorenzo Alcazar because Jason is? Is that it?
If you want to look at it that way, fine. I don't want you anywhere near Jason's enemies. He's my brother, and I trust him.
What about me? Do you trust me?
Why are we fighting about this?
I don't know. Well, we shouldn't be. Look, I'm sorry. Okay, maybe it's just the stress of everything that's been happening around us. I'm sorry. All I know is that the only real thing in all of this is the love that we have for each other, okay? I'm sorry.
I can't wait to marry you. To walk down the aisle of that little church in the woods where we made our promises to each other and vow to spend the rest of our lives together.
I apologize for the interruption. I knocked at the front door, but there was no answer.
Oh, I'm glad you let yourself in. Are you here to discuss the wedding?
I have some unfortunate information. The church where you plan to be married has burnt to the ground.
I already checked the Haunted Stars email account.
How did the fire start? I can't be certain. I locked up for the night. All the candles were extinguished. The lights were off, so an electrical fire is unlikely. The fire department is sending an arson investigator, but the church burned almost to the ground. I doubt they'll be able to find anything.
Do you think it was arson?
Can't imagine who would have started it.
Well, if there's no other explanation, then yeah, the fire must have been set deliberately.
There was a thunderstorm earlier in the evening. Yeah, it's possible the church could have been hit by lightning and the fire was an act of God. Either that or, I don't know, we're cursed.
You burned a church? Well, it was only a wooden building. They didn't even hold regular services there.
You don't think that's a little over the top?
I am merely being creative.
You're thwarting a wedding, not conducting guerrilla warfare.
Nicholas is a Cassadine. Unlike the weak and avaricious Quatermains, he's not easily dissuaded from his heart's desire.
Spare me. Torching a church is exactly what I should have expected from you. Let's just keep our fingers crossed that Nicholas and Emily believe that mumbo-jumbo curse thing and cancel the wedding.
It is imperative that Nicholas believe in the curse. Now, he will only give Emily up to save her.
Hey, you should have asked before you helped yourself.
The odds are definitely against us. Both facing criminal charges, the witness who accused you was murdered, I stained your heirloom wedding gown, and the church we were about to get married in just burned to the ground.
Could be worse. I'm not sure how, but...
You sure you still don't believe in curses?
I believe in us and how strong we are together. And if that curse is real, then we'll fight it.
Yeah, that's right. We'll beat Helena at our own game, okay? Because nothing, not curses or fires or lightning or or both our demented families. Nothing's going to keep me from making you my wife. Yeah.
Not only was torching a church in bad taste, didn't accomplish a thing. All Nicholas and Emily have to do is choose another church or get married in that monstrosity they call home.
We'll have to raise the stakes. We'll have to find a way to convince Emily and Nicholas that their marriage can never be.
That much is obvious.
Then start thinking.
Oh, has your creativity dried up?
This from the woman who hasn't come up with a single idea of her own.
Well, all your harebrained schemes are worthless if Nicholas and Emily decide to go ahead with their plans.
Perhaps I can help.
Daddy! Darling! I guess your heart condition wasn't as dire as we thought. When did you get back, and how long have you been listening?
Long enough to hear you two conspiring.
Oh, well, you must have missed
it.
I would
I'm
never...
I'm not objecting. On the contrary, I agree. Emily and Nicholas should never marry. So count me in. We'll stop the wedding together.
Got it.
Yeah? Let me see.
Our official marriage license, signed and sealed by the state of New York.
It's really happening, huh?
Yeah, I kept pulling it out on the way home and reading it over and over just to make sure.
We should have it framed, put it out on the mantle where everybody can... Oh, no, the salt bag.
Why do you have that?
I was trying to get the stain out of grandmother's dress. I'll clean it up, but...
No. Aren't you supposed to, Yeah, you take a pinch of salt and throw it over your shoulder for good luck. And I forgot which shoulder, though.
Who are you always so superstitious, and I just never noticed?
Yeah, well, not until Helena put that curse on us. Seriously, I mean, look at what's happened since the wine spill on that dress. The church burned down. That nurse who identified you suddenly dies.
Nicholas, those were coincidences. Unfortunate, but that's all. You and I are going to be married. We're going to have a wonderful life. And nothing, no curses, no evil grandmother. And nothing is going to keep that from happening.
Okay.
Everything's in place.
Okay, so Alcazar's going to help you busk.
All right, listen. I got it all worked out, okay? We're gonna get married in secret. Elena and Tracy won't even know we're doing it.
Have you thought about a date?
The justice of the peace is on his way over. He'll be here any minute.
What? You mean we're doing it today?
That's right. Right here, just the two of us.
And what about our family and friends?
We'll have a big reception after we're safely married. We'll invite whoever we want, okay?
Yeah, you're right. This is our chance to take control of our lives and prove... once and for all, that Elena's curses are nothing but empty threats spoken by a madwoman.
My grandmother's threats are never empty.
She can't hurt us anymore, Nicholas. Never again. Would be best.
I wasn't talking about the dress. Listen, I know that you're upset about the wedding gown. I'm sorry.
No, grandmother would want me to be happy, and she knows I am. I can feel it.
No regrets about getting married in private?
I have you. That's enough.
Mr. Cassidy?
Yeah, Mr. Hawthorne. Yeah. Nice to meet you. Thanks for coming. This is my wife-to-be, Emily Quartermain.
A pleasure.
Nice to meet you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Any questions before we begin?
No, not at all.
Would you two mind standing here in front of me? Well, it is my duty and pleasure today to join you, Nicholas, and you, Emily.
All right. Stop. Right there.
This wedding has just been canceled. Nicholas is under indictment for shooting that Mary Bishop person. I don't want you to be part of that.
The Cassadines are a bunch of inbred lunatics. Your children will be homicidal when they accept the rest of his ancestors.
Out. I'm not going to let you ruin this
Emily,
day for us.
Please, will you face the truth before you make a disastrous mistake?
If you really care about Emily, stop trying to destroy her happiness.
If she marries you, she'll never have a happy day
quiet.
In her life.
Stop it. All right, I realize that you're acting out of concern, however misguided. But Nicholas is the man I love, and I'm marrying him whether you like it or not.
Oof. You ingrate.
All right, you got two choices here. Okay? You can either leave, or you can stay and be witnesses to our wedding.
Aren't you listening?
All right,
we don't approve.
All right. We'll do it. Your way.
What? We'll do what?
We'll witness the wedding.
Have you lost your mind?
No. I want my granddaughter to know how much I love her. The way things look now, it's the best way to do it.
Thank you, Grandfather.
And what about Helena's curse?
Well, I thought that you didn't believe in my family's bombastic hoo-ha.
Well, I probably wouldn't have if I didn't see what happened to Luke and Laura.
There is no curse. There's just Nicholas and me in love and devoted to each other.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think I'm going into sugar shock.
Just a minute. Where are you going? Emily's a quartermain. She wants to get married. We'll stay and witness it. And we'll support her.
If you insist. But you and I both know that this marriage is going to make her miserable.
Okay. We're ready. Just keep it short, please.
I'll go straight to the vows. Do you, Nicholas and Emily, take each other to be husband and wife?
We do.
And by the power vested in me by the state of New York, I now pronounce you...
Is he all right?
I'm not sure.
This curse of Helena's is becoming more believable by the moment.
Tell him to get up.
Are you crazy? The man's unconscious.
It's an act. Helena paid him to collapse before the ceremony was completed.
Now that is preposterous.
She's been trying to convince us that her curse is working, and this time she tried too hard.
I knew you were hiding in the tunnel. Everything we said today was designed to set you up.
Over. You can go.
I've got three kids and my wife
will just get out.
My father and I knew nothing about this.
Tracy, don't even bother denying it. Helena wanted you here so you could play all alarmed and upset when the justice of the peace had his well-timed collapse.
Yeah, I'm not surprised Tracy went along with this, but I'm disappointed in you, Grandfather.
You had the church burned down too, didn't you?
Destroy a church, Nicholas. Honestly, where do you get these ideas?
I want the three of you out of here immediately.
Don't expect an invitation to the real wedding when it happens.
Yeah, which it will.
Emily, please.
No, that goes for you too, Grandfather.
It's for your own good.
You know, maybe you should marry him. I think you deserve all the misery you get.
Think what you want, Nicholas. But it's my duty to protect you. They say that a tear must be shed for every spilled grain of salt. Perhaps you'll shed a tear for these while you're in prison for Mary's murder.
Yeah, the Nicholas Castle on here has been pushed back. Room in there for two?
Only if it's a certain prince I'm going to marry for real someday.
I'm sorry that you had to go through the almost ceremony earlier.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm not. We needed to show Helena and my family that nothing they do, not curses.
Hmm.
Her scheming. Her paying public officials to fake heart attacks. And that nothing they do is going to stop our wedding.
I like your attitude. I'll be back with champagne. Today, but it still feels like our wedding day. Sorry, make that wedding night. Maybe we should make this a ritual. Every time we see our families, we spend the next 4 hours in a tub. All right, champagne is ready. I hope that you are too.
Stay tuned for scene 2.